1980s, and we encourage him to invade.
All right, so I just want to get to. I don't. We don't need a history lesson.
From the very first instance, it was about Iraq.
Now, everybody else thought that grew out of 9/11.
No.
Of the national capital today, black limousines with darkened windows converged on a hotel where private security guards imposed ironclad control. The limos carried royalty, political power brokers, and industrial titans to a secret meeting that will last all weekend. It's known as the Bilderberg Group. Could their objective be world domination?
Inside right now, they're deciding on whether or not there will be a war with Iran, whether or not taxes will increase, whether oil prices will be suppressed.
What are these powerful internationalists doing? And why is it so secret? Why does it have armed guards outside? Why is it sealed off? The newspapers totally ignore it. Not a word. Total blackout in the United States.
Yeah, well, Bill Clinton went there in 91, George Bush Sr. back in like 85.
Who we think that we're electing as leaders have already been pre-picked for us.
They have funded both sides of almost every war. And of course, they're getting the interest off of the loans that they've given the various governments and the wars that they have actually helped stimulate and create.
Bilderberg is making great progress toward a world government. And only an educated, informed public can stop them in their tracks.
If you, and I have done many times, said to journalists, let alone the general population, tell me about the Bilderberg Group. This glassy-eyed look comes across. The what? And yet, the major people, they are reporting every day on members of an organization together, different political parties, different countries, everything, and they've never heard of it.
Bilderberg was founded by David Rockefeller and the Rothschilds.
I met Rockefeller through a female attorney I knew. I made a video called Mad as Hell, and he'd seen the video and wanted to meet me and knew I was running for governor of Nevada. And I met him and I liked him, and we used to talk and share ideas and thoughts. And he's the one who told me 11 months before 9/11 ever happened that there was going to be an event. And out of that event, we're going to invade Afghanistan. We're going to invade Iraq. She says, this is going to be war on terror. And he's laughing. Who are we fighting? It was 9/11 that allowed this war on terror to begin. And until we get to the bottom root of 9/11, the truth of 9/11, we'll never know about the war on terror.
We pressed early on for a full-scale investigation. And of course, one of the issues was, while we were doing that, the evidence from the buildings was being destroyed.
The president named a supporter, Dr. Henry Kissinger, Secretary of State in the Nixon and Ford administrations, to head the panel.
And then she asked whether he had any clients by the name of Bin Laden.
Former Secretary of State Henry Kissinger stepped down from the position Friday.
Molten metal
pools under both towers after they collapsed, and Building 7. Now, Building 7 wasn't even hit by a jet, you know, and yet it comes down, and it's got this molten metal underneath.
A correspondent, Jane Stanley. Jane, what more can you tell us about the Salomon Brothers building and its collapse?
Let us never tolerate outrageous conspiracy theories concerning the attacks of September the 11th. Malicious lies that attempt to shift the blame away from the guilty.
Did you just hear what this first responder was saying? The countdown to blow Building 7!
And we also see this molten, yellow-hot molten metal with white wispy ash pouring out of the South Tower just minutes before its collapse. By analyzing this, we determined it is not molten aluminum from the plane. Okay. Indeed, it contains a great deal of iron, which is the product of the thermite reaction.
It sounded like gunfire, you know, bang, 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 bang.
There was an explosion on the basement, and this is prior to the building got hit by the plane.
What floor were you on? Big explosion happened. Some guy came out. He said his skin was all off.
Started walking down the stairs. We made it to the 8th floor. Big explosion. Flew us back into the 8th floor.
And he said, about a year and a half ago on my broadcast, he said, I've talked to military officials, people at NORAD. There was a drill on 9/11 at 8:30 in the morning.
Of all the targets the terrorists could have chosen in London, they apparently elected to attack the same targets as had been envisaged by Visor consultants in their counter-terrorist training exercise.
And the most peculiar thing was, we based our scenario on the simultaneous attacks on the Underground and Mainline station. So we had to suddenly switch an exercise from fictional to real.
We were actually running an exercise for over a company of 1,000 people in London based on simultaneous bombs going off precisely at the railway stations that happened this morning. So I still have the hairs on the back of my neck standing upright.
Sheikh Abdul Rahman, who's been suspected in the World Trade Center bombing, is a paid CIA agent. I thought, wow, that is breaking news. That should be on CNN. But that story never made the light of day.
Yang terbukti belakang bahwa Abu Jihad adalah agen intel. Berarti yang memfasilitasi selama ini adalah aparat intelijen memfasilitasi gerakan Islam radikal.
Secretary of Defense McNamara came on the line, and then President Johnson himself told Geis, I want that goddamn ship going to the bottom.
If any terrorism comes, it's from this government. And if there was an outside threat like a bin Laden, who was a known CIA asset in the 80s, running the Mujahideen war, whose family builds all the military bases over in Saudi Arabia right now, and sits on the board of Iridium Satellite, he's the boogeyman they need. He's the boogeyman they need.
9/11 was done by people in our own government and our own banking system to perpetuate the fear of the American people into subordinating themselves to anything the government wants them to do. That's what it's about, and to create this war, this endless war on terror.
People don't really realize how dire the situation is. They can finesse the issue by having an incident. Oh, Iran attacked our Navy. People will fall for that just like they fell for it every other time.